Welcome to the Hate Watch podcast. We're here with the great Tim Dillon, finally on the show. Trying to get Tim a bigger platform, some more listeners, you know, so...
I'm sorry that it's not a regular member of the Hate Watch podcast.
Yeah, we had to kick John off.
I am very happy to be here, and I thank you for extending an invitation to me.
It just kind of happened. You came over, and then we were going to record anyway.
I cannot believe I haven't been invited sooner. And I was just trying to just do the work.
It's been a little annoying. You said you would do it, and then you scheduled another month of your tour.
People said to me, they go, I said, how do you get on that? They go, just keep your head down and do the work. Keep your head down and do the work. So that's what I did.
Yeah, it'll come. You
is
know?
That a gun?
Is that a real? No, it's a fake AR-15 I do for like videos and stuff.
Oh, it looks very real.
It does. I know. I'm so, yeah.
This is what everyone thinks a podcast studio looks like. a guy with a Kobe Bryant jersey, this photo, and then a gun. That's what everyone thinks. Like, that's what Chelsea Peretti thinks a podcast studio is.
I know.
It's just a bunch of white guys with AR-15s.
That was actually my one fear when you were like, Tim's going to do it, I think. And I was like, he's going to make fun of the studio.
Oh,
he's
I knew he
destroy
would.
The
no,
studio.
I love the studio.
It looks like there's so much Kobe stuff in here. It looks like I assassinated him. Like,
when do you have Ari Shaffir on this show?
Oh, I mean, I don't know.
Would he have like flashbacks?
I don't know. I'm still disappointed in the Crips for not handling that.
Well,
no one cares.
Content.
Yeah.
Digital.
They can't put it on TikTok.
They'll get him with a tweet. They'll show him.
So Tim, did you see the text? We were just talking about Pete Davidson, but did you see like what he said to him?
Yeah.
Posted a picture of him in bed with Kim and all that. And you just said this, and I think it's like perfect that we need Kanye to go to the Beverly Hills Hotel and kill Kim and Pete.
Here's the thing. I don't want anyone to be hurt, but I will say this. We are in a malaise culturally right now because we don't have any real anything happening that's interesting. And the O.J. Simpson trial was very interesting. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Whatever you want to say about the act is not good, but it was interesting. And I think that like whether Kanye killed them or they killed him or whoever killed
either way, it would jolt the nation.
Just
and
something fun at the mm-hmm. the Beverly Hills Hotel kind of wants it too because they're that's kind of a brand that people don't give a shit about anymore, and they're like, yeah, let's get the blood going just to get people excited again.
Right.
And again, I don't want anyone hurt, but we do need something.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I don't even understand this. Like, I read these things.
Like, what's going on with them?
I understand that Kanye's mad at this, but I don't understand why. I don't know. I hate these things because it's like,
yeah.
I feel like I want to be in any of their positions. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean?
Right, right.
I envy all three of those people. So that I feel like commenting on it is crazy. I want to be either one of them.
Yeah.
Kim, yeah. Pete, right. Kanye.
But if you did
I'll
get
take
to,
any of that.
Would you ever be able to actually tolerate them in the environments you'd have to be in if you got as big as where you're like around, you're them? Could you actually being you?
There's
you,
only one way to find out. And I think it's high
run.
Time we try it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, apparently from what I know about the situation, Kanye is unhappy with Pete. And
I think it's really just because it's him, you know, like that, like this guy is with, you know, Kim is supposed right. to be the hottest woman on earth.
But like, that's untrue.
It's not true. It's yeah.
She's a very good looking woman and she's a hard worker and I respect it.
Yeah.
But she's not the hottest woman that's ever lived. But I guess he's upset it didn't work out, mm-hmm. right? I mean, people just want things to work out. And
yeah. Well, it seems it's turning. His narrative was like he was really pissed and he was like stalking them. And now it's just turning into like, I just
who
hate
would he?
Pete
like,
Davidson.
I understand like he doesn't like Pete. And who would it be okay? Like if she dated Colin Jost or something, would that be okay?
There'd probably be less hate.
Was
yeah.
Kanye like, well, he went to Harvard. Like, what's his thought process?
I don't really know. You're right. He'd probably be upset about
he's
anybody.
He's going to be upset.
Yeah.
Kanye.
Why doesn't Kim, because she, all the men that go near her get just destroyed, right?
Yeah.
That's been kind of the Kardashian curse they all talk about. Mm-hmm. Why doesn't she, like, date, like someone who's got nothing going on. Like, does that curse work on guys like with opposite? Nothing going on? Because he's got something going on. Humphrey's got something going on. Lamar Odom, like all the Kardashian dudes. Why doesn't she date a zero who's got nothing going on? And then does that guy just drop dead? Or does he...
Or does he become... Yeah,
does
like,
it work in
life.
Reverse?
Right, right.
That's the question. Does the Kardashian curse only work on guys with upward mobility?
Yeah. I think Brittany fucked that up for everybody.
Oh, but with Kevin Federline?
Yeah.
She tried it
out. She tried Kevin. She got shit all over for it.
Yeah.
And he's doing better than her. He hasn't been living in a cage in Vegas for the last 20
That's
years.
True.
They locked her up.
He's been making money off it. I mean, because of the kids.
Yeah.
So it worked out well for him.
Are you getting ads on this show?
No, not yet. No. We got hit up by Manscaped for a trial run.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's exciting. Let me tell you. We're making waves here.
The last time I used Manscaped, I cut my dick in half. And it's weird because they say it's so safe you could just do it drunk in the tub in the dark.
Is that their ad?
That's the pitch. Manscaped's pitch is like, do it while you're driving. You don't even have to pay attention. You can't cut your dick. That's literally Manscaped's pitch. They're like, no matter what you're doing, it's going to work out. And that is not true.
Yeah, no.
You can hurt yourself.
Have you used the Manscaped stuff?
Yeah, it's good, but you can hurt you. You still have to pay attention.
Right.
You still have to pay attention.
You still have to pay attention.
That's right.
Well,
they're at the Beverly Hills Hotel.
They're
right
at
now.
The yeah. I mean,
we should all go right now to the Polo Lounge. I should get a room at the Beverly Hills Hotel, and
we could hear the murder.
Here's a thought, and this is highly inappropriate, because if we all went to the Beverly Hills Hotel and did blackface and pretended to be Kanye West and ran around the hotel and made a video and called ourselves the Screaming Kanyes. Because there was a group in Provincetown, a gay area in Massachusetts, called the Screaming Davis. Would we still get canceled, or would people go, hey, man, we get it?
Yeah.
I don't think people would still be mad.
They'd probably still be pissed.
But it's a funny idea.
It is a funny idea. And he's the guy we could possibly
fuck with. I've stayed there so much, but I just think that management goes, you know, you've been here and you've shown us a lot of support, but this is really out of line. And I said, I'm just trying to lighten the mood.
Would they ban you, or would they just be like, just don't do it again?
I don't know. But it would be fun to go there. Can I just get a room?
It would be.
You know?
Remember the night we met McGregor there?
We met Conor McGregor.
To, like, fuck Ida.
Absolutely. Or me.
Or you. Know. Yeah.
He wanted someone in the room.
He wanted somebody with him, yeah.
You know?
Yeah. He wanted to come. Ida like gave him your I was like nervous McGregor was gonna bust into your room and whatever was gonna happen was gonna happen that night. It was odd.
Yeah, he's just fucking me thinking it's Ida. He wakes up the next day, he's like, fucking that bitch was a lot fatter than I thought. What a fucking
The lights I was, out front are rather odd.
Oh fuck, I was fucked up. I was really fucked up.
Dude, I just taking care of this like disabled little piece of shit dog right now.
Yeah.
And the minute Tim got here, it like ran over to Tim and bit him in the ankle.
I love this. I'm just looking at now on Decider. Power of the Dog director Jane Campion reacts to Sam Elliott's pod shots. He was being a bitch because Sam Elliott was basically like, why are all cowboys gay?
Yeah. Did you hear it?
Why are all cowboys gay now? He had kind of a point.
He
kind
of did have a point. It was kind of the gayest. It was gayer than Brokeback Mountain.
What does she know about the American West? Every cowboy in it wasn't sucking cock like she said they were. She's a lying whore.
He said that all the cowboys were dressed like Chippendales dancers. And that's objectively wrong. Like, I watched it. They're not.
They were fucking men with families. They weren't out there like Fruit Loops dancing around. They look like goddamn go-go dancers. What West is she talking about?
Sam Elliott also acts like he's like actually like a character from Tombstone. Like he's like Doc Holliday. He's like from Sacramento.
Yeah.
Lived in Portland. Yeah, and he thinks he's like a gunslinger. Yeah. And He's one of those guys where we were talking about actors always, then they start segueing into like, they become, they start like playing the banjo, or they make like vases, like Seth Rogen, like.
Well, I know a guy, young guy, and he like makes cabinets with his dad. He like LARPs, is like a working class guy. He's like a millionaire. Stick a leg making cabinets with my dad.
Yeah, they love that.
We had lunch once at Beverly Hills. He goes, why do you live here? He's like, I can't be in it, man. I got to be outside of it. You're like in it. I'm like, why don't you quit the show? You don't want to be in it? Go work at Walmart. My cousin lives in Pennsylvania, works at Walmart. Why don't you, I'll call him. They're hiring right now. You could quit the show. You don't want to be in it. I live outside of it, man.
This guy's like an actor. He's an actor.
He's an actor. He's on a hit show on Netflix.
You're fascinated by actors. Like, you love like kind of hanging out with them, seeing if they're actually like living the good life.
Well, that's a big part of it. I'm like, is it real? What part of it is real? And how dumb are they?
Yeah.
Like how...
And most of the things you tell me, it's like they're usually like living kind of in a dump and they...
Well, some of them are. A lot of them are just actors or bros. Mm-hmm. So we don't realize about act. Like we've got, when they're 45, they're not, because they're up on stage. They're like, the women made it possible. But when they're 20 and they just want to put their dick in things and they're just famous for no reason, they're bros.
Yeah.
They're like, Trump's kind of cool, bro. Can never say it. They're like bros.
Yeah.
They're good looking bros that just act.
Yeah.
They don't. It's when they get older, they start going like, you cry is so beautiful. Like, it's a whole different thing. What does she know about the Ukraine?
And it's like Steve-O.
She's going to make a movie about the Ukraine where Zelensky's sucking everyone off in there. They had proud Nazis fighting in there in the Ukraine.
What do you think the Zelensky love dies down? Do we get bored of Zelensky? Is it already over?
Because he keeps asking everybody to fire the nukes.
He's the hottest guy that wants nuclear war.
Well, those are, they were never going to win, but it felt like cool thinking they were going to win, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it's going to die. Ukrainian magic.
Yeah.
They're not going to win. It's sad. You know, I'm against the war. Just, to insulate myself from that criticism, I'm against the war. But I will say this, the people that are all into like, oh, Zelensky is going to be, you know, like he's going to be victorious. I mean, it's just probably not going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to get out of there sooner or later. He'll be at the Beverly Hills Hotel pretty soon with Kim and Pete. He'll be with Kim and Pete. It'll be Zelensky. Kanye's like, I'll kill Zelensky.
It could happen somehow.
Absolutely. No, no, no.
Anything said nowadays, I kind of believe
Zelensky's future is going to live in America, and he's going to, like, fucking, right. Yeah, like, that's the fee.
Right.
He's not going to run to Ukraine. Putin's not going to allow that to happen.
Yeah.
He's going to be dead, or he's going to be at the Beverly Hills Hotel, which he could be right now if he left.
Yeah. Now, do you get worried when you see, like, Americans openly say, like, we need to, like, assassinate Putin just because you don't want to upset Putin for nuclear war?
I'm not that worried because nobody listens to what Americans say either. Like, the government doesn't listen to what people say. People have been saying for a long time, can I have insulin? And nobody, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Nobody worries about it. Like, imagine going to the CEO of Pfizer going, do you worry when all these people say they need insulin? The guy goes, no, nobody cares. Nobody listens. It scares me more when people in the government start doing it. But then I think people just, Biden knows. They know you can't get into a thing with Putin.
Yeah.
Can we take this photo of Peter?
I'm sorry. No, it's horrific.
No, it's fine. I just...
It looks like
I don't like the tattoos. A good looking dude, but I don't. The tattoos to me are like, I just don't understand the tattoos.
You see this guy? Russian handcuffed himself.
You
to
have
the
a
entrance.
Switcher, so this is what it'll look like on the thing.
Yeah.
I like the switcher.
You like it? Does Ben not have one? How does he do it?
Well, you know him. He's got 10 stories about how long it takes everything to do. After it's done, I sit in a room for 45 hours to get your voice perfect. I make sure that your voice sounds good in a Kia Electra. I make sure that your voice sounds good. It's very hard. The real challenge of audio is to make it sound good on bad speakers. So I read 15 million YouTube. I went to 15 trillion YouTube tutorials. And then I had to sit there in my backyard for 57 hours and then compress your voice 90 different ways. I'm like, okay.
He's like Rick Rubin.
Yeah.
Did you see this, though? This fat Russian guy handcuffed himself to the entrance of a McDonald's. And he's like addressing Western countries in this. Let's see.
This is great.
He handcuffed himself to a McDonald's.
He looks like he has other intentions to wanting to stay at a McDonald's. Yeah, right.
I don't think he knows a war's happening.
No, he has no clue. These people don't. Oh, wait.
The war's at McDonald's closed. That's the war to him.
I love how, like, we're punishing Russia by taking away, like, the unhealthiest things.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what we were saying the other day.
You keep invading the Ukraine. You're not going to Buffalo Wild Wings anymore.
You can't do TikTok. You can't eat McDonald's. Yeah.
We're just making a generation of very well-adjusted
Literally,
Russians.
They're like, hey, fat pedophiles in Moscow, the fun's over. No more corn syrup and 15-year-old Americans for you.
You can only read Chekhov. We got you. Right, you're going to be idiots.
You're going to have to go back to school and eat food you make yourself. That's the real hell. It's the real hell here.
Are you worried at all about that? Like, what, do you really can you care anymore?
You can't worry.
You've already like made it at literally like I feel like 2 weeks after you like really got big with your career.
Yeah.
Like they told us all to go home, and I was like, oh, this is so Tim. Like somehow your success lined up with like the end of the world.
Then that was a blessing.
Yeah, so and I then it worked out great.
I think everything's a blessing, and I. I think the Ukrainian war is a blessing, and I think that people have to start thinking of life that way. That it's a blessing. What a blessing
it
all.
What if I became that guy?
It's just a blessing, isn't it?
Like you just had electroshock therapy.
Everything's a blessing.
The fourth booster, it's going to be a blessing.
My uncle, he was a very talented guy. He opened for Bob Dylan. He was a songwriter who died of pancreatic cancer very young.
Blessing.
But he wrote a song called Everything's a Miracle. It's a great song, but it's like one of those things where it's just like, you got to adopt that.
Yeah.
Everything's a miracle. Everything's a blessing. This is a blessing.
Sarah McLachlan.
Kim and Peter, blessing. It's a blessing.
Libyan slave trades,
it's
a blessing.
You just can't worry about it.
You can't.
What's that song? Blessed, never stressed. Put on my Sunday best. It's huge on TikTok, that song.
Oh, I don't know. You know way more about young people than
never stressed. It was a huge song. Everybody was like, looking blessed.
Who was the person you were talking about upstairs? What was the name?
Oh, the kid from Minecraft. Rambo. I just love the name. They're all these Minecraft streamers, they're like multi-billionaires and you know, they're the new Russian oligarchs, the Minecraft streamers. And God bless them. I just read one article, became fascinated. I dismiss gaming as this like kind of irrelevant pursuit, but it's this like really layered, immersive experience that people are having that is like far more valuable to these kids than current culture in terms of movies or TV.
Mm-hmm.
And there are storylines and there are things that I completely dismissed.
Right.
I was completely wrong. And I love kind of like totally reassessing. And I'm not saying it's 40-year-olds. You should be doing that as opposed to anything else. But like, I was like, oh, these games are shit. And then I realized, I was like, oh, they've created these worlds. And part of that is the failure of any cultural institution or any platform with any power to do anything good.
Right.
So they've taken over and they said, well, we want to create these things. So that was very interesting
to
me.
It's like their version of a metaverse, basically.
That's
right.
That's right.
Like, I took Ida to Disneyland for her birthday. It was a huge mistake.
It's
the worst
place. I have a joke about you people.
It's awful. And I was realizing, like, oh, that was like, that's like the first metaverse. It was
that's
just
right.
really sad, like, gigantic people in their 40s just, like, trying to, like, just get some happiness by, like, Winnie the Pooh. Like,
well, you know what it is? It's a blessing.
It's a blessing.
It's a blessing. It's a blessing to be 40 and childless and walk around Disney World eating a pretzel. It's a blessing.
There was a blessing. There was like a 600-pound guy pushing his daughter
every minute in life, you're not getting hit by a car is a blessing. And even if you get hit by a car, that's a blessing.
And he had a shirt on that said, my favorite Disney villain is my wife.
Yeah, that's because they're at.
And there's people,
The FBI will take that guy's laptop. He's got like 12 gigabytes of kiddie porn on it.
It's Stephen Paddock's brother.
Yeah, Stephen Paddock's brother in there. And he'll be like, they'll be ripping him out of his house. He's like, you can't take me now. We're booked at the Polynesian Resort in Disney World. Can we do this in a week? I want another Mickey waffle. You know?
I was realizing while I was there standing in line that there's people that bring their kids there for like a couple hours because they have year-round passes. Yeah. They treat it like it's a park, like an actual park.
My mother killed it when we went to Disney World because she actually did the best thing. She goes, we go early in the morning and then we take naps and then we do the night, which I thought sucked, but she's like, we won't be in the crazy heat.
It's actually the move.
It's actually the move. You go there and you take a nap in the middle. You feel like psychotic when you're doing it.
Yeah.
My mother's like, take a nap. And it's like fucking 1 p.m. I'm not really tired. She goes, take a nap. And you just lay in the bed. I didn't sleep. But you lay in the bed, maybe fall asleep, and then you wake up. And then she's like, okay, now we can party till 1 a.m.
Yeah.
And she actually did it right. She actually did it right.
There was a woman in line with her whole family, just a stressed out mom. Like, it's like she might as well be at the store. They're like waiting in line for Who Framed Roger Rat, whatever the fuck. And she's holding her kid by like the bicep, little kid.
Yeah.
And he's like hurt. He's like in pain.
Right.
And she goes to her husband. She goes, we're doing this. We're doing this. Toontown. And then we're fucking out of here.
Yeah. And then we're fucking out of here.
She's cursing in line.
We're fucking out of here. It's a blessing.
It's a blessing.
It's a blessing to be.
Everything's a blessing, I mean, you know?
The funniest thing I've ever seen on a vacation, and I do a character with Ben sometimes. I go, mean dad on vacation, or I say, dad, that's had enough. Every elevator we get in when we're like alone, or even sometimes if there's somebody in there that like just won't like obstruct a bit.
Yeah.
I just turn around to him and I go like this. I go like this. Like, we get in the elevator. I go like this. I go, Jesus Christ. I go, I'm telling you right now, if we don't get a hold of those fucking kids, we're out of here and we're not coming back. Like, the funniest thing I ever saw on a vacation, I swear to God, was I saw a mother, okay, chasing after her two kids. They were running around the pool, and she grabbed each of them like this, and she goes, we're on vacation! And the kids were, like, struggling, jumping away from her. And she just screamed, we're on vacation! Like, I know you act like this when you're home, but not now. We got on a plane and went somewhere else. Not now, you little drug addicts.
Oh, man. You see some of these families and you're like, it's a miracle that they aren't all like murder suicide and someday. Like, you can't even, I can't believe there's not more stories of people killing their kids. And like, truly, everyone looked so sad. And the only happiness they had was the split second that like Winnie the Pooh takes a picture with like the kids. It was so depressing.
The thing about Disney World is that it is I hate places where you're constrained by the expectations constantly of what it's going to be.
Yeah.
And that's the thing about Disney World, where like you've built it up in your head to be a thing, and then you got to see every minute of it. New York is like this. I worked in tourism for a while. I was a tour guide on a tour bus. And people in New York, we get on a bus with like a schedule. I'm like, man, it's the worst way to see New York. Mm-hmm. They're like, I got to see the Empire State Building. And then we want to get a bagel and then go to Brooklyn. And then we got a Broadway show. And then my husband's got tickets to a Knicks game. It's like the best way to see New York is to just kind of like, you know, just walk around,
ease into it,
flow in and out of things. But like these people that are like, you know, they go, this is it. I have this amount of time to see things.
Yeah.
They want to see the things. And it's very like stressful. And people had horrible times. People had horrible times.
Like you would see people have like horrible times. I hate time. New York. This is
crying.
Awful. Yeah.
We missed the show. Like I remember our tour buses, we were for a very bad company. And the way the tour bus system works in New York is it has stops all around New York City. And we sell you a 3-day pass, meaning that you can get, it's called hop on, hop off. You get on, you get off. Uh-huh. And it takes you all around the city because people still think in the subway, well, now you are getting stabbed again. But back then you weren't. People thought the subway was dangerous. They're like, it's too complicated. We can't use it. And they're like, cabs are $1 million. We'll pay $50. We get 3 days on and off this bus. The problem is sometimes the bus doesn't come. And then sometimes the bus comes and it's full of people and you don't have a seat. Right. And literally we'd pull up with a full bus and there'd be like 50 people trying to get back on this thing because they've had it. They're like sunburnt. They wouldn't see the Statue of Liberty. Yeah. They're just trying to get back in their hotel room. And we'd wave to them. We'd go, another bus is coming. And you wouldn't even get through the sentence of another bus is coming. And they'd be like, straight up, be like, you fucking lie. Oh, fuck you. And like the kids are, they're holding sunburned kids. You're like, and people just had horrible times because New York is a very high-pressure vacation. Mm-hmm. It's not a beach. You're not sitting there.
No, it's hard to fit everything if you're there for 3 days.
Yeah.
You
can't. Like, L.A., people don't even know what to do. There's nothing to do.
People come to L.A., they ask me, they're like, I went to Hollywood Boulevard. I'm like, oh, what a trip.
Like people say to me, like, what should I do in L.A.? I'm like, disown your family and ruin your life. I don't know. Move in with a failed screenwriter and start taking Adderall.
Yeah.
Do a ketamine treatment.
Yeah, right.
Growing up in LA, I never understood what the charm was. Like, until I got older, I was like, why do people care about LA?
Well, because
like
there was a fascination with Hollywood. But now that you see people just don't give a shit anymore, what's happening is, like, those tour buses are, like, barely full.
Oh, yeah.
People don't. And nobody even knows anymore the people.
Who are they visiting? They're like, that's Stephen Yeun in Walking Dead. There he is. Like,
yeah, no, nobody even knows what's going on. And, like, they have to get so old, like, the celebrities they talk about. You know, they're like, and we're heading up to the canyon. You're going to see where Bill Pullman lived. And people are like, what? You're like, what are you talking? Where's Rambo? They're like, Bill Pullman. Wasn't he in Twister?
Yeah, Twister.
The movie with Helen Hunt, Twister.
Yeah. Like, to your left is where William Frawley used to vacation.
Yeah. Yeah, and then, like, all the big, like, big celeb, like, they're, like, just, you can't see anything either. It's just hot, like,
you just see a wall, like, it's a fence, yeah.
Can't see anything. So they just point to Craig's, and they go, this is where all the celebrities go to eat, and you can't afford it. That's also part of, like, what I used to do on my tour. I would just point to apartments and go, $80 million, $100 million. Like, I remember one woman tried to get the better of me one day. She's like, she was from Britain, but not the part that had money. She was from the other part, you know, up north. And she's like, yeah, you, all these apartments are so much money, but they don't even have central air. They've got wall unit air conditioners. And I'm like, that's because they live in historic buildings. Many of them have central air in their 30,000 square foot Hamptons homes. They take Heller's copiers to them. Do you have any other questions, you toothless pig? And then she I didn't say that, but I said exactly that, except toothless pig. And she's all, oh. And she settled back and was like, she was trying to make the world make sense in her head. Like, we've all got central air, so I'm actually the same as them. I'm like, hey, piggy pig,
right.
Not today. Okay.
Yeah. Well, technically, we all sleep.
We're all the same. Yeah. It's a blessing. It's just a blessing to be here. It's
just the guy that shows up to every atrocity. He goes, it's really a blessing.
You know, ask me seriously, like, about, like, the Ukraine or something like that. I'm going to be that guy.
Well, what do you think of the millions of women and children fleeing Ukraine due to the bombings and the you know?
You know what I've learned? You know what I've learned in my life? I've learned many lessons, but the greatest lesson I've learned is to see the world for what it is. And do you know what it is? It's a blessing. It's a blessing that comes in the package of a horrible war. It comes in the package of a horrible, bloody war. But what it really is, when you look harder, it's a blessing. Do you know why?
Why is
that? Because we're talking about it. And when we give love, have you ever given love? There's this is what they talk. Yeah. This is literally what they sound like. I literally could make money doing this.
Oh, 100%.
She's like, it's not about, we all know what making love is, and we all know what taking love is, but have you ever given love? And when you see the Ukrainian flags, and we're donating, and we sing the songs, we're giving love, and that's a blessing. Now I'm going to go back to my estate in Malibu and pay a Taiwanese ladyboy to jam a bottle so far up my ass, I'm going to have to see a doctor, and I'm going to sniff a bunch of lines of ketamine, and then I'm going to go see Whitney Cummings' new hour.
So it's a blessing, I guess. It's a blessing. That's how you see it. Yeah.
It's a blessing. All the boys and girls. Gary V. Gary V's like, content. Content. That's how you get out of it. Content. That's how you get out of it. So what you have is you have this country right now that's being ripped apart. You're just being fucked up. Fucking ripped apart. Okay? Do you know what it's like to be one day you're sitting in your bedroom, the next day you're fucking outside of your bedroom, you're not even in it anymore. You're outside of it walking, you don't even know where you're gonna do. So what are you gonna do when you're walking? So you're walking how many times? So from Ukraine to Poland, what is that? 70, 80, 100,000 miles, whatever it is. How many TikToks can you make on the way to the border? How many times? How many YouTube videos can you do on the way to the border? You can have three companies. By the time you get to Poland, you'll be a millionaire in Poland. It's a blessing.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, the Ukrainians need to have more of a hustle and grind.
No excuses.
How are the renters? Grind. Do the renters care about the yelling?
You know, I met her earlier today. She seemed good.
What's her deal?
So, I don't really know. She seemed like a nice lady. She was just
her first night here, we were like,
no, she wasn't that other bitch.
We go, let's not pog. It's her first night here, and then we were just doing it.
No, I don't care cuz I met her.
Yeah.
I hear people fuck all the time. I've heard interesting lots of things. So yeah. I don't. It's, you know, the house was built in like 1910.
Yeah.
This is a blessing.
This is where the Black Dahlia was killed. It was a blessing.
It's all a blessing.
Do you know who this guy is, Tim? Clay Travis?
No.
Who's Clay?
I've heard the name.
He's like on Twitter, right winger, I guess, or whatever. I thought this was funny because it reminded me, like, one time you told me that you were like, there's a lot of your followers is like young right wing guys they love you, but they also don't get that you're not that, like,
yeah, they don't understand like the enemy of their, like, it's that enemy of the enemy is my friend. It's like I hate a lot of like things they hate.
Right.
We hate the same things.
Yes.
But that doesn't mean we like the same things. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Exactly. Yeah. So I don't, this is just a quick thing, but he said something that this sums up that type of guy well, what he says here.
It's not on the screen.
And they said, look, you can't have this opinion. It's too conservative. We're not going to allow it. I think that's a bad move. I'm a First Amendment absolutist. I believe in only two things completely, the First Amendment and boobs. And so once they made the decision that they were
not going to allow conservative, non-sports-related commentary,
they couldn't do it either.
Hold on. I just want to make sure I heard you correctly as a woman anchoring the show. What did you say? You believe in the First Amendment and BWBS?
Boobs. Two things that have only never let me root down in this entire country's history, the First Amendment and boobs. So those are the only two things I believe in absolutely in the country. And so I don't think Jemele Hill should be fired. But I do think, straight up, that once you make the decision that you are going to let Kurt Schill...
Now, well, even if this guy was making great points, it's like he's just, you say something like that and everyone's like, well,
yeah, you know what it is? It's these guys keep trying to be funny. And right. They don't understand that funny isn't leading with an ideology all the time. So everybody that just leads with an ideology all the time can't... You just, it's by your nature, you will not be funny. Mm-hmm. It's just, so don't try to be funny. Just make the point.
Because you already have a team that you're playing for.
Well, it's not only that, it's like your brain, your brain does what you train it to do, right? Like your body does what you train it to do. And if you're trained to constantly just serve the food that the people want, whatever it is, you're then figuring the joke structure that your brain is going to come up with is beholden to that. Mm-hmm. So everything goes through a filter, and if your filter is you good, you bad, this horrible, this great, then every time you think of something that's funny, it's got to go through that filter, and you got to throw away a lot of stuff that doesn't work.
Right.
And
right.
It's stupid, right? I mean, it's like it just limits you, and you start saying shit like that. Then a guy like that's going like that because he in his world, he's like, I'm saying boobs to the CNN anchor. He thinks it's like edgy.
Yeah. Yeah. He but thinks it's like Howard Stern's
butthole.
And
then she reacts like a typical idiot too by going, what did you say? You heard what he said.
They both just playing.
You know what? You're having him on for him to say that.
Right.
Right.
You're having him on to make great points. You're having him on to say that. He said it.
Yeah.
Everyone did in this clip what they should have done.
Yeah. Yeah.
He said, I like the First Amendment and pussy. And she was like, why would you say that?
Yeah.
And you know, and then they don't let the black guy talk. So I mean, that's the whole. It's a perfect representation of the mainstream news.
Yeah, he got a show at HBO after this, but they didn't let him speak. The black guy.
Oh, well, I'm good. I want to hear from him. I'm sick of the other two. And boobs are two things that never let me down. Because that's not the funny angle. The funny angle isn't boobs have never let me down. The funny angle is, yes, there were some times when boobs have let me down.
Right.
So that's the whole thing. But you're trying to say, I'm a straight man, I love boobs, and you can't stop me from saying the word boobs. Has anyone ever stopped straight dudes from saying boobs? Has anyone ever, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like
yeah.
Now, I guess now with the trans stuff, people get, it's like whatever. It's like they're, you know. But at the end of the day, it's like, that's not fun. It's not funny to say that.
Yeah,
it's only funny if you're dumb. Like, the audience is dumb. He's maybe not dumb. He's probably not dumb. He's making millions off dumb people that just want to hear dumb shit. Mm-hmm. Like boobs. They're boobs. He said boobs. They don't want him to say boobs, and he said boobs, mama. The funny angle is boobs have let me down. Once I was fucking this girl, and one of her boobs was, like, deformed. And the other one, like, there's something funny right, about that.
Right. But he thinks he's like, I'm taking boobs back. Like, for too long, men just haven't been allowed
It's this weird thing. And again, it's just for the audience, right? It's the people that are.
Yeah, I just thought it was a clip. It was like a perfect summation of everything.
It's that thing,
basically.
He goes, two things that have never let me down are the First Amendment. But man, the First Amendment lets me down all the time. What are we talking
about? Yeah, what do you mean?
These are just dumb things. So you're saying you've never said anything that's let you down? You never said something that didn't work out? How lucky are you? So when you start unpacking these ideas, that's what I mean about ideology. We all agree with the First Amendment. When you start saying dumb shit, like, First Amendment's never let me down, boobs have never let me down, your wife's never not picked you up at the train station, boobs let people down all the time. So that's why they're allergic to funny.
Yeah.
Because they're just, it's all like cheap horseshit.
Right, right. But why does it seem like in the last like 5 or 6 years that right wingers think like they know who the funny people are? Like,
because the left has abandoned their job as being funny.
Right, right.
So it's being filled in by a lot of people that, you know, whatever are not like pledging allegiance to the morals and values of the day.
Mm-hmm.
That's what comedy should be. It's poking holes and taking down sacred cows. But the whole game now is like, well, these cows are too sacred to take down. Well, they're supposed to not be any cows. Like, oh, we can't make fun of trans people. We made fun of when people were religious. They thought they were going to burn in hell when Carlin and Hicks said what they said.
Yeah,
and they said it. The whole point was to take down. There's no person or entity shouldn't be needlessly cruel in your humor, but there's nothing in the world that's so above. It's above humor.
Mm-hmm.
So when you decide that there's all these protected classes of people that are above humor and ideas that are above humor, then you create this vacuum where people will fill it in because people want jokes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, I think a lot of trans people wouldn't mind funny jokes about that. I think it's a humanizing thing that we can all make fun of each other. Somewhere along the line, that's been lost. So you have people like to come on and go, I believe in niche and boobs because boobs ain't never let me down. And it's like, okay, man, I don't even know what that means.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, it doesn't even make sense. It's just, he's like, I'm going to say boobs on CNN, baby. He told his wife right before.
I'm trying to be funny, but it's not. That's not the essence of funny.
Yeah.
The essence of funny is if he said that, like, you want to really attack a woman, go, I support the First Amendment, but not when you talk, toots. Like, that would have been funny. You know what I mean? Just attack her. Be like, hey, honey. Hey, sweetheart, when you go blab the old pie hole, like, you know, do the old colloquialisms,
right.
You know, the old slapping raccoon, Georgia, you know, the dancing with the raccoon guy.
Yeah.
Do all that stuff. Be like, honey, when you open the old pie hole, I'm not really an absolutist. You know what I mean? And then just go with her like that, you know?
Right.
You know, do something real funny. Go like, you know what's funny? Here's a funnier bit. People are going to get mad about this. This is funnier, though. If he goes, I believe in two things, the First Amendment and rape. And then she's going to go, excuse me? And he go, yeah, I believe in the First Amendment and raping people. And then if she goes, what do you mean by that? He goes, I'm kidding.
And then the other guy at the panel goes, well, me too, actually. Yeah.
Like, you go, I'm kidding. Of course I don't believe in rape. It's a joke. Of course I don't believe in rape. But you think I'm going to say that, so I said it.
Right, right. Yeah. Yeah.
Jesse
got sentenced. Richie, what did you say it was?
Did they say it in there. I don't remember exactly.
All right. Well, he did like a big show. He did a big song and dance.
I love how hard Ben makes all this look. You're doing it like literally as we do this. Ben's like, this takes 17 hours in post.
30 months felony probation, and the probation is going to be to this court. You're going to be allowed to travel wherever you want. You do not have to live in the state of Illinois. You can report by phone. I know that you want to...
How come his lawyers don't have masks on, but he does? He's just trying to look like a liberal.
I don't even know what's going on anymore.
Try to make a living and do some of the things you do. You may have to go to other places, New York and Los Angeles. You can do those things.
That's over.
You pay a restitution to the city of Chicago in the amount of $120,106. You are fined $25,000, which is the maximum fine, and you will spend the first 150 days of your sentence in the Cook County Jail.
That's it? 25 grand?
Dude, right no here, boobs right for 150 days, dude? Mr. Smollett. Are you serious?
So the jury found you guilty, and I've sentenced you as I have. You have the right to appeal the findings and rulings of the court or ask your sentence be modified.
Here's what was really dark about this. There was like two guys in jail, and they came up to him. They're like, could it have been these guys? Like, they were like, maybe it's them. He's like, it's probably them. Like, if they were two white dudes, like, he would have just let them go down.
They would have just like, yeah.
Yeah, he absolutely would have.
You mean those Somalian guys that he like hired or whatever?
Well, no, they were like, they went up to him and this was something like that happened where they were like, basically like, I think we picked up two guys. It might be them. He's like, it's probably them. Like, something like that. God. Yeah. He would have just let somebody go down.
Oh yeah. He's the equivalent of like, the Charles, not Charles Bradley.
What a weird move to revive your career. Just go, let's do a hate crime.
So strange.
It's strange, but it just shows.
But it also is perfect in a weird way.
It's perfect. He got a job. Didn't he get something right
now?
Hey,
I think he like got, like, he was like, even after we found out it was a lie.
Is this from like the Bohemian Grove, this?
That owl thing? I don't know.
That's where I used to work, and Ida took it when I let you go to that event.
So now let's see. Does he react to this?
Oh, yeah. He does like a, he like acts. He does like a big, like he does like Shakespeare.
Yeah.
Appeal in writing within 30 days. You may also file a motion to modify your sentence, which would have to be filed in writing within 30 days. Anything not stated in those filings are waived for purposes of appeal. You cannot afford lawyers or transcripts. They would be provided free of charge. Do you have any questions?
No, I was just
Oh, shit, he's taking the mask down for this one.
I am not suicidal. That's what I was about to say.
I am not suicidal.
I am not suicidal.
Okay?
I am not suicidal. I am innocent, and I am not suicidal. If I did this, then it means that I stuck my fist in the fears of black Americans in this country for over 400 years, and the fears of the LGBTQ community. Your Honor, I respect you, and I respect the jury, but I did not do this, and I am not suicidal. And if anything happens to me when I go in there, I did not do it to myself, and you must all know that.
And I believe that a world...
Jail time.
He goes, it's a blessing.
Yeah. It's a blessing.
I'm not suicidal.
Okay.
Does he think he's like Epstein? Like the deep state's right, gonna kill him? Like,
well, this is how crazy it gets, right? This is really now. There's not one. Are they gonna make fun of this? Did SNL do anything in this?
Oh, I don't think so. I think this happened like today.
Let's see if they do. Like again. I mean, you want to talk about just the insanity of like refusing to make fun of this because they all fell for it. They all got suckered into it.
No, I watched the clip. Hey, not what I saw. They didn't make fun of it.
Right. So the whole thing is like when you get suckered into something. You know, and you go, well, white supremacy is the greater threat, and this guy might have lied, and well, of course he lied. Like,
how many times have white people lied?
There's a ton of fake hate crimes, by the way. Nobody wants to talk about the rash of like fake hate crimes that always get exposed as fake when it's like a swastika that nobody knows how to draw.
Right.
Oh, they're Nazis, but they don't know how it works. And these things at college, like badly drawn nooses hung around, are always found out to be like fake. Like this idea that America is just a country teeming with Nazis running around committing hate crimes is provably untrue. Not to say there's not tons of racism and tons of, you know, structural impediments to black people succeeding, of course, blah, blah, blah. A lot of, if you're a fair-minded person, you believe all that and you believe that there needs to be changes to laws that actually help people, right? That being said, this kind of idea that America is just teeming with people drawing swastikas on walls and it's just not statistically true.
No, the like in high school, there was just like dumb kid. There was like kids would go to the bathroom and draw a swastika. Yeah. People would be like, he's a neo-Nazi. Like, he's just bored. He's just an asshole.
Like, yeah, but I do like, like, I do think he's not a bad actor. Like, he gets up.
He's
there
good.
He's good. You see the potential, and you go.
He's got that melodrama. It's like good for like, you know, those Stars
now,
shows.
What is the reaction to this? Like, I think Black Lives Matter tweeted like, we support Justin.
Black Lives Matter. They sent him a house.
Yeah, they just bought him a condo.
They bought him a condo. Said, well, first comment, dude is a clown. Take your L and keep it moving. He's just embarrassing himself.
No, but like the real, like not the
like
YouTube
Twitter?
Comments. Yeah, like
wanna go to Twitter?
Saying? What are people saying about
let's go to
this?
Devan loves to go right to YouTube comments. We'll be like, what are people saying? He's like, let's see what
I think
the
YouTube,
biggest retard
YouTube
on
comments
Earth
are
says.
The nation.
They're the voice of the nation.
Jussie Smollett.
I saw a bunch of people making fun of him on
yeah, I'm sure there
I saw
are.
Like, I think I remember seeing like Andrew Schultz just like show the video and just be like, ha 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 ha, like you're a clown.
Oh, Kyle Rittenhouse? Here we go. What did Kyle Rittenhouse say?
He's going to sue him.
Kyle Rittenhouse, the media called me a white supremacist from the start and instantly called Jussie Smollett innocent. I'm thankful for our justice system in America. It doesn't work like the dishonest media. Refuse to get the answers before declaring the innocent guilty and the guilty innocent. Now, God damn it, if I'm not going to get a big fat Domino's pizza. I want garlic sauce with that Papa John's, mama. I want some Papa John's. Papa's. Should they do a commercial with Kyle Rittenhouse, Papa John's?
They probably will.
He's just eating.
You called it. He's everything you say happens like 5 months later. It's kind of creepy,
he's
actually.
Yeah, you're like
scary.
Alex Jones. It. with media, yeah, but with media.
Thank you.
Alex Jones called the war. Have you seen that clip, Tim?
He called it like till
well,
to the
called
day.
Something.
He said in October. By the end of February,
no, late
February,
yeah, late February,
Russia will invade Ukraine, and we're gonna have a big problem on our
yeah,
hands.
Yeah, he did. I did texted him that actually. I was like, oh, you called it? Yeah,
crazy.
But you know, I don't know. I just there's shit that seems obvious. Mm. It seems obvious. This is a very interesting thing. This is the highest profile fake hate crime we've ever had.
Mm-hmm. And what was crazy to me is the lack of outrage about it, I thought. Like, it kind of really got swept under the rug.
Yeah,
quick.
Well, now we're beyond human. We're beyond the, like, we're in a post-fact society.
Yeah.
No one cares. You tell someone a fact and they go, all right.
The longest news story to stay in the news cycle has been Kanye and Pete Davidson.
Yeah, it's crazy.
The war hasn't even stayed in the media.
Because we're dying
the news
for
cycle
the harmless,
long.
Like, tabloid-level thing, you know? Like,
yeah.
Like now it's all heavy. It's all, there's another plague or nuclear war. We just want bullshit. Like, we want Brangelina. We need, like, dumb couples to get together and distract us.
We want... But we're trying to force it. No one really cares either about the Pete and Kim. Like, no one gives a
it
shit.
Isn't.
Like,
yeah,
we talk about it because we had nothing to talk about. And what are you going to do? You know, you put it out there. You go, yeah, it's happening. We give it a few, try to get a couple of chuckles off it, and we move on. But, like, it impacts no one. It says nothing about anything. Like, all it suggests is that it's the further descent into mediocrity. We're like, you don't even care anymore about the quote-unquote biggest stars of the day doing whatever the hell they do. No one cares. I mean, we live in a time now where truly no one cares about anything. And if if it came out that like the government admitted to doing 9/11, there'd be a high majority of the country that go, eh,
right,
whatever.
But you didn't already know that, like,
or they'd just be like, they'd be
you?
Like, fucking, hey man, I'm more concerned about the traffic everywhere than them doing 9/11. It was a long time ago. I'm just concerned about traffic. You can't get anywhere anymore. They go, they attacked, they killed us, and they said it wasn't. Yeah, man, but like, let's talk about what they can do good.
Yeah, can't live in the past, man.
Can't live in the past, man. It took me 30 minutes to get into town. That's crazy. It's traffic.
You'd think there was another 9/11 with the traffic I just went through.
If three 9/11s get this traffic out of here, I'm into that. People don't care.
Yeah, you're right.
People don't care, and because caring now is insane. That's we've made caring
like,
insane.
Yeah, passion is like gross.
It's insane. It's more than gross. It's like if you care about something, people think you should be put somewhere. Like, if you come in,
right.
You know, and you're like, people just go, good, we'll get, yeah, out of there.
Right.
People go, please. Like, this is all the process of, like, putting up the black square and, like, stand with Ukraine, all these things. It's all how to not care but pretend to care.
Right, right, right.
Have you ever met somebody that really cares? It's terrifying.
It's Alex Jones.
It's terrifying. Most people now are just like, stand with Ukraine. Why are we going to brunch? Because they don't care. But if they got to that brunch and they were like, we got to get weapons. We got to get over there. If we can get to Poland, they're not flying out. We can fly to Poland. We can go to the border. Like, that's really caring, right?
Right, right.
Like,
right.
I don't care about my life. Don't you want to die for something that means something? You go like this, you go, Becky is fucking nuts right now. Like, I don't want to die in Ukraine.
Yeah.
But you said you stand with the Ukraine. I do, but then let's stand with them for real. Like, that, it would be crazy. It's like the Capitol rioters were crazy. Like, a lot of people were like, yeah, the election's shady, but then some people showed up in like helmets and hats.
Right.
And then ran through the Capitol. You go, oh, those people are crazy. Yeah. Like, people, yeah, cops are fucked up in the country, but then you see like people throwing bricks and burning down federal courthouse. You go, they're crazy. So it's like, we've made caring crazy. And it was by design, right? I mean, it's not something that's by accident. It's like, the people in power, and they just make it. They go, yeah, if you care about anything now, we're going to make you seem crazy.
Yeah.
So here's the way to care about it and not seem crazy. Here's what to tweet. Here's what to post. Here's the hoodie to buy. Mm. If you go any further than that, you're going to seem like a psychopath. Mm-hmm. They have marches. I mean, I remember in like Belgium, there was this big child pedophile case. They shut the country down. They had this massive march because they were like trying to sweep it under the rug. And I forget, Belgium, one of these countries, they literally like, I think it was Belgium. They had this massive public display of like, no, none of us are going to work until you figure this shit out. Like, what's going on here? But, you know, again, we make that stuff in America. We co-opt it immediately. Like, any protest movement, immediately you get real psychopaths. Then the CIA gets in there. They go, let's start throwing bombs and shit. Yeah. So that regular people are like, what the fuck is this? Nothing ever gets done. It's by design. It's pretty smart.
Right.
No, you see it in, like, Canada. Because, like, there's been a bunch of protests, but they were meaningless. And then the most effective one, they're evil. But that's what an effective protest is.
Yes. Yeah.
You shut the economy down.
If you fuck things up, it's effective. Yeah. But then, no, now you're evil. And
right. That's what you're supposed to do when you protest.
They want performative protests.
Right. Yeah.
You know? With saying that, Tim, do you ever
bar
think...
bar crawl.
Do you have any conspiracy about, like, somebody that died young and people, like, there's conspiracies like, oh, they were killed because they had influence. Like, Bill Hicks, John Lennon, like, they cared. Or people, like, Stanley Kubrick was finishing Eyes Wide Shut. And, like, there's, like, the dumb, you know, rabbit holes you can go down of, like, people thinking they were taken up with
Chris
the
CIA. Cornell or, all that stuff.
Because they cared about, like, human trafficking and shit.
I don't
like
know if they killed Ralphie those May. People. I think
Ralphie May,
them.
Of course.
Yeah, Ralphie May. He was trying to change this.
He was trying to really change the ordering system at Hometown Buffet.
That was a threat. I think they killed the people that I've seen them kill are the people that are in they're about to make the change. The JFKs, the Martin Luther Kings, the people like that. Like, that seems to be the people they kill. They will also kill people if you have a USB file of something they've done wrong and they don't want it out. They'll kill you. Michael Hastings, probably, whatever.
Right, right.
I do think they kill journalists, certain ones. I do think that they kill witnesses that have information in cases. It's not impossible that they kill celebrity. I've never been convinced of that, but I've also never thought it was impossible. Maybe it scares me. I don't really want to believe that they kill people. But I think that the way that they keep a lid on all of this, I think, and the way that they do it, it is the brilliant kind of two-party yin-yang system. Like, that's truly the way they do it brilliantly, because they just divide people on such a predictable way, and they've been doing it forever. And then the people that are supposed to be these revolutionaries, like the AOCs or the whoever, or on the other side, these, you know, retards and Marjorie Taylor Greens or whatever, all they do is divide. All they do, everything they do, they don't build a coalition, they don't do anything. So like if you keep that going, you're fine,
right?
You have to keep that going. You have to keep people hating each other.
Right, because if you ever solve anything, then what do the people do that have jobs in terms of fighting sides?
You have
sides?
To keep people hating it. You have to keep people invested in the idea that they're winning against someone. They're owning the libs. They're owning people. All the while, every president does roughly the same thing. It's kind of a brilliant system. It's like the pundits go crazy. Like, yeah, fuck it. And then, like, the people on Twitter hate each other. And so they're all invested that, like, it's a tomorrow's a big deal. We're going to vote. And if it doesn't work the way we want, fuck. We're going back home for 4 years and then we're going to fight even harder. But then the reality is you look at Trump and Biden and you look at the policies and you go, they're very similar. They're certainly very, very similar on, like, national security. Like, for example, the dominance of certain sectors of the economy, the financial sector, the tech sector, they're dominant sectors. They call the shots. Everybody else, kind of everything flows downstream from whatever the fuck they want to do. And those things just stay the way they are no matter what. But the rhetoric just gets so crazy that people forget that. Mm-hmm. People would act, Republicans now act like Joe Biden is like Mao Zedong. He hasn't done anything. He hasn't even done it. He hasn't done anything. He didn't do the student loans. He didn't forgive anyone. They didn't do anything. He's not giving away piles of money. Like, they act like the guy went in and goes, we're nationalizing everything. No, he's taking orders from the same people that Obama did and Bush did and everything. They're not doing anything. Trump didn't. Liberals acted like Trump came in and like, you know, he didn't do anything. He did a sloppy immigration order, reversed immediately. He didn't do much. Truly, if you look at the way he governed,
right.
He didn't govern that differently. But yes, was it crazy on Twitter and did he do other shit?
A tabloid
sure.
level, yeah.
Yeah, but when you look at the actual nuts and bolts of laws changing and like things, you know, did Trump get in there and go, we're out, we're not back in Israel anymore. We're pulling out of this, we're pulling out of that, we're doing this, we're doing that, we're investing in this instead of that. We're taking a major sea change where, no, he said he was going to change the carried interest loophole on Wall Street, he didn't. He said he was going to build a wall, he certainly didn't. He said he was going to rein tech companies in, he didn't do that. He campaigned on reining Wall Street in, he certainly didn't do that. So again, it's like, you know, it's at the end of the day, not to be uber cynical about it, but the reality is, it's just a show. And if you say that, you're accused of like being uncaring or not whatever. Doug Stanhope had a great point. They go, why don't you care anymore? He goes, remember when I cared?
Yeah.
So it was a great Doug Stanhope point. But like, this is what's fascinating to me. The people get whipped up into a froth over all these things. And then the inertia of certain things happens. It's just going to happen. Like trans stuff, it's going to happen. Like, yes, 4-year-olds shouldn't be doing, you know, irreversible things to their bodies, and there should be discussion about that. But trans people are going to have a place at the table. Gay people, black people, it's just whatever. These things end up happening. Mm-hmm. But also what ends up happening is the companies that dominate and control you have more and more of a say in your life every year. Every year. The corporate state grows bigger and bigger. The national security state, the corporate state, the fusion of the public and the private, you know, they get more intermingled, more intertwined, and they get bigger and bigger and more powerful. And there's not one politician out there that's ever in my lifetime even attempted to reverse any of that.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Blue Chew, if your dick doesn't work, if your dick isn't working and you want it to work better, go to Blue Chew.
Have you heard people say, like, where they're like, well, this wouldn't have happened under Trump. Trump said that also. Do you believe that just because, like, he would have, like, spoken to Putin a lot?
This is a
or
thing.
Something? People, like, is there any way to know?
This is a wasted, pointless thing that people do. It's my favorite thing. Well, if I was. What are you talking about?
Right, right.
It's a different set of circumstances. I have no idea what would have. Trump is no longer the president.
Yeah. Like, if Michael Jordan played today.
Yeah. People are hanging on to this shit because, again, they are completely. Trump pulled a con on his supporters, like very few people successfully, you know, and very few because, like, you know, he said he was going to do all these things. He really didn't do them. And then all of these people were kind of left holding the thing. So now they've resorted to being like, well, if he was in now, it wouldn't have. So I'm like, well, he was in for 4 years. And what about all the shit he was supposed to do?
Right.
How about going through that? Where's your wall y'all wanted? How about this carried interest loophole on Wall Street where these hedge fund guys are paying like no taxes on the money? Like, what about that? Mm-hmm. All these tech companies that keep kicking you off, he could have done something about like breaking them out or like starting to get into that. What about that? But it's this fantasy again of like, well, no, but if, you know, he was in, we wouldn't have the. And these are the same people that agree with Putin. What do you care?
Right.
You agree with it anyway. This is the other thing. You're like, Putin's got the right to do this. And if Trump was in, he never would have done it. It's like, Well, then what are we even saying? Yeah. It's politics schizophrenia.
Yeah.
It's schizophrenia. These people that have these two ideas in their head. Putin's doing the right. I agree with Putin. He's restoring the dignity to the holy, you know, the fucking Christian Russian people and his godless globalism of America. They go that route, and then they also go, and it never would have happened if Trump. Well, then what are we talking about? What are we saying? Like,
right.
What?
Yeah.
So it's schizophrenic. You have to be schizophrenic. The people on the left are like, racism's the worst thing in the world. If you see a Russian, spit on them.
Yeah.
What? We shouldn't be racist, but Russians don't get to breathe. So it's just schizophrenic. You have to, it's knowingly becoming schizophrenic.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I think all there is to do is watch this Joker on Roku. Have you seen this show, Tim?
I have not.
I wanted to wrap this up with you because this is basically anytime you
I love
over,
Sam Talent, though. He opens.
All the comics in it are, a lot of the comics are great.
I love Sean Patton.
A lot of the comics in it are great, but it was just, it's just a funny thing because, you know, there's some where it's like I've never really heard of them. And it's like this new thing where celebrities are like, how do I get, like, what's hip, kind of? And so they're like, well, like, Will Smith is like just trying to figure what out, what to do now.
Yeah.
And so he's like, let's, what are, like, what are comics up to? And it's him having like interviews with these comics and he's fake laughing at like everything.
I think it would be a better
say.
Show if Will Smith convinced them to join Scientology because
he did that. What's the reading where they read the.
Yeah, he
he's
goes,
there.
Let's go,
like,
yeah, let's go get a fucking, like, what do they call it? Meter, e-meter reading?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
E-meter
yeah.
reading, yeah. yeah.
He's the, and he's the... there and he's like, he's studying them like Jane Goodall. Like studies chimps, like there's a look in his eye where he's like, you've been, he's like, you've been doing this for 20 years. Yeah. The guy's like, I live in my car, you know. And he's like, yeah, he's Will Smith. It's just
that's
the
crazy.
Juxtaposition is hilarious.
Comedians to Las Vegas to showcase their material.
Will Smith's rock bottom was Wild Wild West, and that was a $50 million rock bottom, bitch.
We talk about art, life, and see what we can learn from each other. No plan B, it distracts from plan A.
This is probably a bad time to bring up that I'm taking real estate classes.
This isn't a competition. This is an opportunity.
Yeah, it's like comics being like this. You're like, I can't afford my medication.
He's, like, he's just dying laughing.
He's like, isn't that great? You love it.
He's
That's
like,
called
well,
love.
He's like, well, we're going to put your Venmo in the, you know, in the comment section. Yeah.
I mean,
do you think the stand up, the all the specials and all that shit's coming to an end at some point? Like where they don't just keep throwing anybody a special on Netflix?
We're in a malaise. We're in a great malaise here.
You ever think there'll be a comedy movie that's ever good that you don't make? Are you going to make it? Let's make it.
There's a million things that will be done that I have nothing to do with that'll be brilliant. But no one cares. You know, there's a great line from The NeverEnding Story, and it's more or less, says it, the rock creature. And I want to get it up right now. I want to, because let me see if let's see what Ben does here. Let me try. Morla. Never. And this is my favorite quote about anything. It's a little bit. It's not that long, but I don't know where the quote is, but
okay.
What do these people watching have to do?
Oh, yeah. No, there's nothing going on.
Okay, we can fast forward it. Okay, hold on. Okay, so here's what I want everyone to imagine right now. The kid Atreyu is like all of us. Right? Or wait, hold on. The kid Atreyu is like the section of people that still give a fuck, and then the turtle is like just the general, you know.
This is what it is,
right?
That's impossible. He couldn't have heard me. Are you Mola, the ancient one?
Not that it matters. Yes.
Please help me, Mom.
This is the United States.
This is such a great
it's amazing.
Analogy.
We haven't seen the Orin in a long time.
We? Is there someone else here, too?
We haven't spoken to anyone else. Of so we started talking to ourselves.
No, it's just brilliant.
Oh my god.
Now he sneezes. This is all the fentanyl and the McDonald's. That's the fentanyl and the McDonald's coming out. I'm telling you, folks, stick with this.
I bring terrible news. Did you know that the Empress is very ill?
Not that it matters. But yes, actually, we don't care.
If I don't save her, she'll die. There's a terrible nothing sweeping over the land. Don't you care about that?
We don't even care. Whether or not we care.
Wow. That's it. We don't even care whether or not we care.
Holy
I mean, that
shit.
that's kind of really what it comes down
yeah,
to.
Mic
we don't
drop.
We don't even care whether or not we care. I mean, that's the whole thing where it's like, that's the malaise. The malaise is like we've been so beaten down in every direction all over the place that,
it's another level of apathy.
Yeah, it's just looking for solutions now in anything and looking for inspiration from cultural centers or whatever. I mean, it's just you gotten to a point where it's like, you know, I mean, good things will happen by accident, and then some people may notice them. That's the best. That's the best I can give you. Good things will happen by accident, and occasionally some people may notice them. But I do believe this all heads in the direction of, you know, just, you know, there's too much. This diet that we're all being fed is too intense for us. We're not going to be able to handle it unless we upgrade ourselves with that fucking Elon Musk shit that everybody's like, that vaccine will kill me. And then they're like, Elon Musk's going to put a thing in your head. And they go, oh, that's good. I like him. We're going to Mars.
Yeah.
And people, a lot of people have made that point where it's like they're looking at this guy and they go, well, this is good. This Neuralink stuff is good, right? Isn't that good? And you're like, that's exactly what you're but we're not going to be able to handle this without the upgrade. We have to upgrade our systems to handle all this shit, so that's when we start to become fused with these things. And the internet makes you lose your humanity, and we've seen it. You see it all the time. You see, like, an old woman running through the streets instead of just going, oh, my God, you go, well, NATO is and you go, just have the human reaction, like, oh, my God, that's horrible. Right. You can debate why it happened, but there should be a human reaction first, but there's not, because you're not a human anymore. You're literally not a human anymore because of all this shit. And 50 years from now, the humanity's good, because you'll be able to get rid of a lot of diseases. They'll be able to get rid of a lot of things and imperfections with people. They'll start to look similar. They'll start to have similar, you know, the genetic sequencing and stuff like that, that they're going to experiment just to start designing people. And before you know it, what's going to happen is, like, these reactions, these human things that we're having right now, it would be insane for three guys with a fake AR-15 and Kobe jerseys to even have these discussions in 50 years, because everybody's going to be just, like, so similar and on the same page if this continues the way it does, where we just become part of this.
Yeah.
Where, like, we're no longer invested in these great collision. Like, everyone thinks that, like, you know, it's going to be like boot on the neck fascism, but I think it'll be like people are going to be very happy and thrilled to live in little pods and get their little meals of whatever, and they'll be happy, and because so much of their thing will be hacked. It's going to be hacked with, like, these human emotions that they possess are going to be, like, isolated, considered antisocial, considered a potential weakness, and you're going to breed them out of people because those people are going to be unemployable and not sociable, and they're not going to be able to live places. And, like, so you're going to breed them, and maybe they'll be in some District 9 somewhere going nuts, but most human beings, or whatever's left of what a human being will be at that point, are not going to want to live in District 9. Mm-hmm. They're going to want to be part of the thing. And the thing is going to be that you'll be less. So we're the problem, but they're getting rid of us soon. That's the good news.
What a blessing.
It's a blessing.
It's a blessing.
It's all a blessing.
It's all a blessing.
It's all a blessing. This was very good.
Yeah.
This podcast, I thought it went very well.
You were great.
I think it's good.
I think you're always great.
I think it's great.
It was good. Thank you for doing it.
Thank you for having me.